Ooh, something big, something big, something big.
Oh my God.
Right there, right there.
There we go.
Oh yeah. Oh, you good, Platty.
Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo, baby.
Let's go. Look how thick that flounder is.
Oh, my goodness.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Out here in the marsh, mid-morning, we didn't get an early start. We was waiting on that tide. The tide has now just started to move in. Going to be targeting flounder and redfish today. Plan on keeping a few reds. Hadn't kept redfish in a long time. Wanting to put some of those on the grill, on the half shell. If you enjoy inshore fishing, give my channel a subscribe. Give this video a like. Enough talking. Let's rip some lips on some fish. Stay tuned. We are fishing Mississippi waters today. There is no flounder closure in the state of Mississippi. It is November, and we're gonna see if we can get on some bigger doormats. Tide has just started coming in. Water clarity is not that great. We have had a lot of unseasonably warm temperatures. Water temperature is still 78 degrees, and it's November. So that'll keep those flounder in for quite a while. What I usually see year to year is the flounder will stay in till that water temperature gets about 63, 64 degrees. And then they'll move offshore to spawn. Ooh, them no-see-ums are tearing me up. Look at all of them on my arms. This'll take care of them. If y'all follow my channel, y'all know I'm a believer in this Marsh Romance and Skeeter Hawk, both excellent products from Hawk Soap Company. I'll leave their website link down in the description below. This is something you cannot live without in the marsh. I guarantee you it works. It's all natural, no DEET in it at all. Shake it up before you use it, and it will work for sure. Great guys. Company is based out of Louisiana. Some really good folks. All right, back to fishing. Mm-hmm. Y'all flying around me now. Y'all ain't biting me no more. Right there. Right there.
There we go.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you good, Flatty. Good one. And we just getting started, fellas. That's a good one right there. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo, baby. Let's go. Let's go. Woo. There we go. Woo! Boom, baby. Woo, let's go, let's go. Look how thick that flounder is. 19, baby. 19. Let's go. All right, big girl. Let's get the old hook out of your mouth. Beautiful 19-inch flatty. We're going to put a tag in her and release her. All right, big girl. All right, big girl. Let's give you a safe release. Thick, thick, fat flounder. Woo! Woo! She gone. She got me, too. I love it. Yes, let's go. All right, flounder number one. Nice, fat 19-inch flounder. Tagged and released. Let's see if we can get some more. Man, she hammered it too. Hammered that fish bite dirty boxer. in the tap out color. Y'all look at my arm. Look at all the dead no-see-ums on there. Tell me they're not thick, and tell me that Marsh Romance from Hawk Soap Company doesn't do the trick. Love it. I mean, we ain't been fishing 5 minutes, fellas. Just giving those baits a little twitch pause. That's the retrieve I always use for flounder fishing. And it works. Bump, bump, pause. Bump, bump, pause. Bump, bump, pause. Using 20-pound braid to a 20-pound fluorocarbon leader with my 5-second knot and my teaser rig. I'll leave links at the end of this video to how I tie my 5-second knot and my teaser rig. Gotta give them fish a buffet. Give them some choices, give them some options. It allows me to throw two different color baits and two different profile baits with two totally different actions at the same time. Boy, you could not survive out here today without some good bug repellent. Look at all of them buzzing around me, around my camera. Right there, right there. Got another one. Had a horrible hook set, but I got the little guy. Not what I was wanting, not a big doormat, but he will get tagged and released. Flounder number two. See, he wanted the brawler. Little guy sitting on 11 and a half inches. Now that is like a 1-year-old fish, 1.5-year-old fish. Got a lot of them mixed in here, which is good to see as well. See you, dude. All right, that's one 19-inch flounder on the dirty boxer, and then one little tater chip on the brawler. That's what I love so much about this teaser rig. You're fishing two areas of the water column, two different profile baits, two different color baits with two different actions. Definitely unseasonably warm for November. Out here, short sleeve shirt, shorts, sand gnats everywhere. I prefer fishing a falling tide, but when the tide just starts to rise, when it's not way up in the marsh grass, is a really good time to target flounder. But it's warm. Air temperature's like 77, 76, 77 degrees. Beautiful day in the marsh. When the weather finally does cool down, we will be targeting redfish, speckled trout, sheep's head, all that good stuff. Right now, we still gonna be hitting the flounder. Oh my goodness. Ho, 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 ho. Drag pulling redfish, baby. Woo! Man, that's a strong fish. Thank you. All right, let's go. Let's go, baby. Pretty guy. Pretty guy. 21 inch red, perfect eating size red for sure. We will be keeping that guy, putting him in the box. Hadn't kept red fish in a long time. Want to keep me a few. Let me show you what I do with these red fish. They've got a little soft spot right under that side fin. You can stick your finger in there, just like that. And those fish will bleed out. Be a lot better tasting. Do that on each side. Yes, sir. Redfish number one. Let's go. All right. What a fun fight. Like I said, I hadn't. Y'all watch my channel, y'all know I ain't kept a redfish in a long time. But I got the craving for some redfish on the half shell for me and the wife. I only really need two fish to have what we need. So hopefully we can catch another red. Got another one. He ain't gonna make the cut. Pretty guy. Two spots on one side, one on the other. See, dude. Right here, baby. Another flounder. No, it ain't. Another redfish. Pretty little guy. Got to be 18 in Mississippi. I don't think he'll make it. Nope, a little short. Pretty dude, see ya. He wanted the old brawler. Oh, something big, something big, something big. Oh my God. That was the next cast. Did y'all see him? Did y'all see him hit it on the water? Whoo. Another nice flounder. Boat flip. Oh. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Let's go. Another nice thick. I mean, look how thick that joker got shoulders on him. 18 inches and he is thick. Hopefully he didn't swallow that hook too far. All right, got the hook out. He's gonna be just fine. Man, what a nice, nice fish. Wow, what a slab. I love the fall. Whoo! Love it. Bye-bye. Got me again. Brother, we are on some fish this morning. Hey, if y'all are enjoying the video and hadn't subscribed yet, please consider subscribing. I'd appreciate it. Really help my channel grow. Let's get back in here, rip some lips on a few more fish. Heck yeah, let's go. Let's go, baby. Another nice flounder. Right here in the mouth of this creek drain. I tell y'all, I preach it. Y'all follow my channel. Fish points and the mouth of these little creek drains. That was a redfish and a nice, fat, fat, thick fall flounder. Right here, back-to-back cast. That was so cool how that flounder thumped it. Hopefully that'll show up on the GoPro. And for the record, I wouldn't recommend boat flipping 18-inch flounder. That joker was thick too. He has some shoulders on him. Here we go, here we go. Got another one. That's a red. Another rat. He wanted the brawler. All right, don't be swinging that hook over on me. Pretty guy. Thick for his size. Trying to cast just as tight to that shoreline as I can. Because redfish will be cruising along that grass line, plus flounder with this incoming tide will start nosing up to that grass. Give that bait a little bump bump pause. Just keep working it right down the edge of that grass line. Right there. There we go. Oh, he's digging. He's digging. He's digging. Another good one. Another good one. He ain't as big as a mother. Look at him. Just look at there. Bye-bye, dude. Easy come, easy go. He was about 17. He wasn't quite as big as that last one. Looking at him in that clean water. Got a little slack in the line. They will get off. I was going to tag him and release him anyway. We got to redeem ourselves now. He was tight to that grass line, just like I knew he'd be. And he hit the dirty boxer. Been about half and half today. That's what I love about that teaser rig. Like I said, I'll leave the link to that video at the end of this video. Really, to me, it is the ultimate flounder fishing rig. Some days all they want's the jig head, some days all they want's the teaser. About half and half today. Oh yeah, there's my other red. Woo, pull and drag. Yep, that's my second red I wanted. Oh, he's pulling drag. Got some fight to him, boy. Let's go. Let's go. Woo. Man. Man alive is that rascal. Man's he got some fight to him. And he's not huge, but man, they are fired up. Perfect Perfect eating size redfish. All right, got redfish number two. That's what I was after. All right. All right. Woo, let's go. Twenty-two and a half. Yes, sirree. Pretty guy, for sure. We're going to do him the same way as we did the other one. Just take that finger, stick it. There's a soft spot right there. Stick it right in to his gills. And that fish, as you can see, will bleed out and be a whole lot better tasting. All right, let's go. Definitely a hard fighting fish. Boy, those reds are fired up today. Let's see if we can't catch one or two more fish before we call this video. Right there. Right in front of the boat. Let's go. Right in front of the trolling motor, I tell you. Right in front of the trolling motor. Still a nice thick fish for its size. Good hook set right through that top gill plate. Get tagged and released. All right. Thanks for the fight, dude. See ya. All right, let's go. Got another one, tagged and released. I just love being out here in the marsh. Not another boat in sight. Man, I love it. Catching some nice thick flounder, nice redfish. Life is good. That's the key, is hugging that grass line real tight on that incoming tide, because that's where those flounder are going to be. Like I said before, they'll nose up tight against that structure, tight against that grass on an incoming tide. I threw right on top of one, y'all. Right there. Threw right on top of him. He's a little guy, but I mean, I threw right on top of him. See, dude, I mean, as soon as that bait hit the water, I saw a little bit of mud, poof, a little puff of mud. He was on there, right there. There we go. Got another one. Ain't moved a boat. It's a better fish. Better fish. I preach it every video. Leave them poles down. Fan cast the area. Another nice thick flounder. Sitting on 16 and a half. We'll put a tag in him and release him as well. See you, dude. Right there.
There we go. Got another one. Boom, baby.
15. Boom, let's go. We on them, boys. We are on them today. All right, let's go. See ya. Bye-bye. Boom, let's go, baby. We are on them this morning. That joker thumped it, too. I saw the water boil up. I knew without a doubt we had a flounder. Right there. Got another one. Got another one. Oh, yeah, baby. Oh, yeah. Another flatty. Got another one. Woo-hoo-hoo. Yeah, let's go, let's go, let's go. Boat flip. Unfortunately, that guy took it a little deep. We may have to end up keeping him. Unfortunately, he did not make it, but we'll put him in there with those redfish, and he'll be awesome. All right, everybody, we're fixing to wrap this video up. Hope y'all enjoyed it. The marsh was absolutely on fire this morning. Caught a ton of flounder, some nice big thick fall flounder, some redfish to cook on a half shell with some Cajun seasoning, some butter. Ooh, man, that's gonna be awesome. Hope y'all enjoyed the video. Like and subscribe if y'all hadn't already for weekly fishing content here along the Alabama and Mississippi Gulf Coast. If you didn't see me in the bayou, you can see me right here on Bayou Bandit Charters every Sunday morning, 9 o'clock. Thank y'all. See y'all next week.